Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. Today my topic is antiplatelet drugs. Antiplatelet drugs are drugs which prevent adhesion, aggregation of platelets and inhibit the release of platelet-derived vasoactive substances, that is aspirin. Aspirin's most important drug, it is acetylsalicylic acid. It comes from willow bark. Salicylic acid is very toxic for stomach irritation and it is the most consumed drug in the whole world. And also it is the over-the-counter drug, mostly consumed for CVS indications. Now the classification of antiplatelet drugs. At first, it inhibition of prostaglandin synthesis is aspirin. Inhibition of ADP-induced platelet aggregation is ticlopidine, clopidogrel. Blockage of glycoprotein 2B3A receptors on platelets are abciximab, eptifibatide, tirofiban. Inhibiting adenosine uptake and cyclic GMP phosphodiesterase activity are dipyridamole and cilostazol. Now the antiplatelet drugs are aspirin, clopidogrel, ticlopidine, dipyridamole, sulfinpyrazone, abciximab, eptifibatide, tirofiban, cilostazol, epoprostenol. What are the pharmacological effects of aspirin? The pharmacological effects are anti-inflammatory effect, analgesic effect, antipyretic effect, antiplatelet effect. And nowadays we use aspirin only for its antiplatelet effects. What are the indications of aspirin? Indications of aspirin are mainly serious indications such as transient ischemic attack, cerebrovascular accident, acute MI, unstable angina, deep vein thrombosis, pulmonary embolism, disseminated intravascular coagulation, prosthetic heart valve. What are the contraindications of aspirin are peptic ulcer disease, bleeding disorder such as hemophilia, purpura, liver and kidney disease, patient undergoing elective surgery before or after or during labor, and children. Now the mechanism of action of aspirin. Aspirin is used, low dose aspirin is common use for antiplatelet action. Low dose aspirin is 75 milligram to 100 milligram. It inhibits cyclooxygenase pathway in platelets, permanently inactivate this pathway, so no thromboxane A2 is synthesized from platelets, and some thromboxane A2 is not synthesized, so no vasoconstriction and platelet aggregation, no thrombosis and no antiplatelet action. What are the adverse effects of aspirin or GIT effects such as nausea, vomiting, gastric irritation, hyperacidity, ulceration, perforation, bleeding in the form of hematemesis and malignant. It causes salicylism, causes tinnitus, hearing difficulty, vertigo, dizziness, headache, confusion. In children, it causes race syndrome, that is hepatic encephalopathy. It also causes analgesic nephropathy, allergic rhinitis such as urticaria, bronchial asthma, angioedema, and metabolic acidosis and respiratory alkalosis. Aspirin is contraindicated in pregnancy because in first trimester, due to risk of teratogenesis, it may cause cleft lip, cleft palate or telepace, or it may also cause abortion. Near the term, it is contraindicated because it may cause delayed labor, which is dangerous both for mother and for fetus. Profuse bleeding due to antiplatelet effect, dicumbaro-like effect, and also causes patency of ductus arteriosus in the fetus is impaired and causes fetal hypertension. Aspirin causes bleeding in GIT because stomach has an offensive mechanism, that is hydrochloric acid. Stomach has a defensive mechanism, such as a mucus bicarbonate ion tight junction. This is called mucosal barrier or cytoprotective mechanism of stomach. These two mechanisms are regulated by prostaglandin of gastric mucosa. Prostaglandin causes decreased hydrochloric acid secretion, and potentiation of defensive mechanism. Now, aspirin inhibits prostaglandin synthesis, which results in increased hydrochloric acid secretion and weakening of the defensive mechanism and causes bleeding, hyperacidity in stomach in acidic medium, blood and intracellularly alkaline medium. So aspirin as acidic drug is absorbed easily in stomach in acidic media, but it dissociates within the cells, that is basic media, and deposits on submucosal blood vessels, erosion of blood vessels, and causes bleeding. Now the adenosine receptor antagonist thionylpyridines, the main agent of this group is clopidogrel. Recently pasugrel has been introduced. Ticlopidine was the first to be introduced and causes neutropenia and thrombocytopenia and is now little used. Mechanism action of these drugs. These drugs inhibit ADP induced platelet aggregation by irreversible inhibition of P2Y receptors on platelets. Unlike aspirin, these drugs have no effect on prostaglandin metabolism. Pharmacokinetics of clopidogrel. Clopidogrel is well absorbed when administered by mouth and in urgent situation is given orally as a loading dose of 300 mg followed by maintenance dose of 75 mg once daily. It is a prodrug and is converted into its active metabolite by enzymes in the liver. Drug interaction may occur with other drugs such as omeprazole, so it should not be used with omeprazole. Now the clinical uses of clopidogrel. Clopidogrel is slightly more effective than aspirin in reducing outcome of ischemic stroke, MI or vascular death. It can be used instead of aspirin in patients with symptomatic atherosclerotic disease, but because of cost is usually reserved for patients who are intolerant of aspirin. Combined treatment of aspirin reduces mortality in patients with acute coronary syndrome or MI given for 4 weeks. Pre-treatment with clopidogrel or aspirin followed by longer term therapy is also effective in patients with ischemic heart disease undergoing percutaneous coronary interventions. And now the adverse effects of clopidogrel. Clopidogrel can cause dyspepsia, rash or diarrhea. Thrombocytopenic purpura may occur. Ticlopidine causes hemorrhages, neutropenia, thrombocytopenic purpura. The clopidogrel is preferred over ticlopidine. Now the dipyridamole. It inhibits platelet aggregation by several mechanisms. By inhibition of phosphodiesterase enzyme, block of adenosine uptake into cells, inhibition of thromboxane A2 synthesis. Now the clinical uses. Clinical uses of these drugs. Modified release form of dipyridamole reduce the risk of stroke and death in patients with transient ischemic attack by around 15%, similar to aspirin 25 mg twice daily. The beneficial effect of aspirin dipyridamole are additive. Adverse effects are headache, dizziness and gastrointestinal disturbance, but it does not increase the risk of bleeding like aspirin. Now the glycoprotein 2B or 3A receptor antagonist are abscisinate FTP-butite tirofiban. Their mechanism of action are blocking glycoprotein 2B or 3A receptors on platelets. They inhibit the final common pathway of platelet aggregation. Abscisinate is a kind of monoclonal antibody is used in high-risk patients undergoing coronary angioplasty along with heparin and aspirin. It reduces the risk of restenosis. Immunogenicity limits its use to a single administration. Tirofiban is a synthetic non-peptide. FTP-butite is a cyclic peptide. Neither of these drugs is absorbed if administered by mouth, given intravenously as an adjunct to aspirin and heparin preparation. They reduce early event in acute coronary syndromes. Other antiplatelet drugs are epoprostenol, the synthetic prostaglandin I2 or prostacycline, an agonist at prostanoid IP receptors on vascular smooth muscle and platelets. It is chemically unstable under physiological condition. It is given as intravenous infusion. Half-life is 3 minutes. Mechanization acts on prostanoid receptors, on vascular smooth muscle and platelets, stimulating adenine cyclase enzyme and thereby causing vasodilation inhibit platelet aggregation. Hypoprostenol, clinical uses to prevent thrombosis during hemodialysis, especially heparin, is contraindicated. It is also used in severe pulmonary hypertension and circulatory shock. Adverse effects are due to vasodilation. It causes flushing, headache and hypotension. Other hypoprostenol, synthetic prostaglandin I2 and agonist at prostanoid IP receptors. Its clinical uses are to prevent thrombosis during hemodialysis, especially if heparin is contraindicated. Now, overall, aspirin inhibits cyclooxygenase irreversibly, low dose, very effective, more than 95%, inhibit platelet thromboxane A2 synthesis and reduce the risk of thrombosis. Clopidogrel is a prodrug given by mouth. It irreversibly inhibits P2Y receptors and thereby inhibits platelet receptors. TDP, its clinical effects is additive with aspirin. Prasugrel is similar. Antagonist of glycoprotein 2B3 receptors include a monoclonal antibody. Abscisement several synthetic molecules that is TOP1, they inhibit diverse agonists, for example ADP and thromboxane A2, because different pathways of activation converge on glycoprotein 2A3B receptors. They are administered intravenously in short-term treatment. Now, these are the antiplatelet drugs. Hope you stay home, stay safe, be aware of coronavirus. Take care.